Hello, welcome to my channel, PsyClinic, Center for Healing Minds. You are going to listen to an audio series, Cure Anxiety in Easy Ways. I'm your host for the series, myself, Tarun Verma, and I am a clinical psychologist. I practice in Delhi, India. In this audio mini-series, I will discuss with you about anxiety, mainly generalized anxiety. People with generalized anxiety disorder, GAD, may benefit most from this series. However, the audios are equally useful for those with other forms of anxiety too. The series is in English, and I hope you will be able to get a basic idea and some useful information about problems with generalized anxiety and how to cure them using simple strategies of mindfulness and thought or belief modifications. Please note that this series is not a substitute to any therapeutic procedure and may not be able to help you beyond a certain extent in case you are experiencing chronic problems related to your anxiety. Please consult a specialist to get help if you are not able to deal yourself. You cannot reach a definite diagnosis about yourself or someone else through these audios, so please do not self-diagnose anything. For that, you may have to consult a specialist only. It is expected here that you know some facts about your anxiety problems and have consulted a specialist who has suggested you to go for psychotherapy. In that case, these audios can be of great help. Once you will know in some detail about ways to manage your anxiety through this series, seeking therapy will be quite easier for you because you will know what to expect from your therapist. On the other hand, some of you may not have consulted any physician or psychiatrist but want to manage anxiety on your own because you know what you are going through and how you want to help yourself. The information contained in this series is brief and will give you a view into the practical ways that are necessary to cure anxiety. The problems that you are experiencing may be mild to severe, hence, for some people, this information may be sufficient, while for some may not be satisfactory at all. Therefore, a detailed evaluation of anxiety-related problems is necessary to cure the issues which may be associated with many other factors. Don't get disappointed by any failures in applying these techniques or due to your inability in understanding the concepts outlined here. With practice, you may get better in achieving anxiety-free life. The series has 6 audios, which are very easy and simple to understand. So let's begin with our first audio. What is generalized anxiety? Feeling tense, stressed, and worried at certain times when under pressure is a normal human response. In fact, 2 out of every 5 people report that they worry at least once every day. However, for some people, their worry, feelings of anxiety and tension persists to the point that they significantly interfere with their daily life. If this sounds like you, then you may find the information in this audio very helpful in understanding what generalized anxiety is and its relevance to you. What is worry? Before you can understand generalized anxiety, you need to have an understanding of worry. Worry is generally regarded as a form of verbal mental problem solving about potentially negative future events. It can be triggered by a variety of external events or from thoughts that just pop into your head. Worry is characterized by a lot of what if statements such as, what if I fail my exam? What if I can't do the job? What if I can't provide for my family? What if I get anxious during my interview? Normal worry is relatively short-lived and leads to positive problem-solving behavior. Worry becomes unhelpful when it is about a number of things, is very frequent, and is difficult to control or dismiss. People may think this type of worry is useful, that it helps with problem-solving and planning or prevents future negative outcomes. However, this is not the case, as prolonged or frequent worry generates more anxiety and more worry, which may actually prevent positive thinking and action. What are the key symptoms? Generalized anxiety involves anxiety or worry about several things has occurred for at least the past 6 months. The worry is experienced as excessive and uncontrollable, is present most days, and interferes with the ability to focus on tasks. At least three of the following symptoms also need to be present for the past 6 months or longer. Feeling restless, keyed up, on edge and unable to relax, physical tension, sleep disturbance, having trouble falling asleep, maintaining sleep or experiencing unsettled sleep, problems concentrating and focusing on a task, feeling irritable, feeling tired or exhausted easily. What are the causes? The causes of generalized anxiety are not clearly understood. However, a number of vulnerabilities are considered to increase the chance of developing generalized anxiety. An inherited general biological disposition to experience negative emotions, prolonged stress and past experiences of uncontrollable or traumatic events, direct or indirect messages from the people around you that the world is threatening or that worry is useful, a coping style that involves avoiding challenges or situations where there is the chance of experiencing negative emotions. Diagnosis and treatment. Generalized anxiety is not always easy to diagnose as some of its symptoms overlap with depression and other anxiety problems. It is thus important to see a mental health practitioner for a definite diagnosis. The recommended psychological treatment for generalized anxiety is cognitive behavior therapy. This usually includes relaxation to reduce chronic tension, techniques for dealing with unhelpful beliefs about worry, learning to challenge and let go of worries, learning more helpful coping and problem-solving strategies, and learning to be less focused on uncertainty and more present-focused. Mindfulness training and meditation may also be helpful for some individuals to reduce worry and increase present moment focus. However, more research is required to determine if it is as effective as cognitive behavior therapy. This ends our first audio. Hope you have liked it and understood what was described here. Please watch the second audio for further information. Thank you.